Good afternoon, my wonderful students. This is the home management teacher, Mrs. Oduma. I'm here to teach you laundry process practical. That is practical on laundry processes. Now, remember in our second week, we treated laundry processes and the removal agents. Do you understand? That is what we treated in second week. But this time around, we want to learn on how to launder our clothes. That is the practical aspect of it. But before then, I still want to remind you to be observing your safety measures. They are very, very important. Do you understand? Please don't play much. Go online, read your book, play your video clips, and get ready for your CB test. Do you understand? Remember, I said our topic today is practical or on laundry processes. Yes, that is our topic today. And at the end of this class, I want each student to know the reason why you need to launder your clothes. At least to be able to know the reason why your clothes need to be laundered. Do you understand? Then you'll be able to list laundry guidelines, how you go about it. Do you understand? And you'll be able to launder your clothes yourself and that of the household. Is that taken? Yes, that is what I want us to achieve in this particular class. Now, what are the reasons why you need to launder your clothes? Number one, they will last longer. I just want to tell you that if you launder your clothes, they will last longer. There's no two ways about it. Take for instance, this clothes that I'm putting on, if by the first time I wore it, I didn't wash it, I won't be able to wear it again because moss and some dirt must have gathered on it and it won't look new again. But look at it today, very fine. And look as if I made it today because I laundered it and I ironed it properly. Do you get? Then it's more cost efficient. Yes, if you are the type that believe that, oh, after all, there are dry cleaners out there, that they I'll give them money, they will launder my clothes for me. That is not always the best because you need to save costs. Take for instance, you are spending 2,000 naira every week to launder your clothes. Okay, calculate it in a month. You will know how much it will worth. Then, times it by 1 year, you will know that you are spending much. But when you will be able to know it and know how to handle your materials based on the material you want to launder, you'll find out that it will be doing you more good than as in spending excessively. Are you getting it? Now, it's better for the environment. Yes, if you are laundering your clothes always or as it's supposed to be, you find out that your environment will always be friendly. Do you understand? You will always be getting fresh air. Because in a home or a house where dirty clothes fill the laundry basket, dumped there, if you enter, if you put your head, you will perceive some offensive odor. Do you understand? Which will even make you uncomfortable. But when you are laundering your clothes as it is meant to, you find out that, oh, fresh air, you have enough ventilation, fresh air will be, you will be free to accept your visitors. Keep getting it. So it's better for the environment. And then at the same time, it will not allow all these household pests to be loitering about the house because they are not getting any bad odor. They are not perceiving any bad odor. You know, they live in a dirty environment. But when your environment is very neat, they will not see a hidden place. Is that clear? All right. We say that prevention is better than cure. Now, let's take it this way. Okay, situation whereby you did not launder your clothes. Okay, you have a stain of tea or all these sweet things on your body, and you now remove it, put it, even drink all these minerals we are drinking, mistakenly pour on your clothes. You remove it and put it in the laundry basket. Do you know that cockroaches and some other household pests can trace that and start eating your fabric? Before you know what is happening, it will spoil the fabric. Then, instead of you now using your fabric as new, you will be trying to see how you can manage it, how you can, maybe, can I cut off the hand? So that I will see. To prevent all these things, it is better you wash it, keep them neat. Wash them as soon as you notice the stain, so that you don't give room for any household paste to penetrate on them. Is that taking? Now, it helps the practice of good hygiene, just like as I said earlier. Even you yourself, if you are laundering yourself as I went you, you find out that you'll be full of yourself. Like me, I launder almost every day. Why? All the clothes my children use in sleeping, I make sure I wash them early in the morning before going, even coming to school as a teacher. Do you get? But the day I do my proper laundering work is on Wednesdays and Saturdays. Those days, I will do my proper, all the clothes they must have worn Monday, Tuesday, and the one of that Wednesday, I'll wash them in the evening of Wednesday. Then the one of Thursday, Friday, and the I will wash everything on Saturday. Tidy up the house. Do you understand? That's how it's supposed to be. Some might choose to be doing their own 3 times in a week, depending on how your work can permit you, or how your activities can permit you, so that you'll be maintaining good practice hygiene. You practice good hygiene in your environment. Is that taken? Now, that hygiene is very, very important. If you are a neat person, whenever you are looked for, or anybody sees you, the person will be able to know that, this is a neat person. He cannot abhor death, and so on and so forth. Do you get? Now, I want us to quickly look at a video. A video of how to launder our clothes. Now, look closely to this video. You can see the lady just selected her clothes, he dumped it in water. Now, he's about to wash it. Do you get? First of all, check the level to know, is it the one I'm going to wash with warm water, hot water, or thereabouts? Is now sobbing it. Do you understand? As you have checked the level, sobbing it in water. Remember, when you are washing, don't stretch. It's not all clothes that you need to stretch. You can see cardigan in that bowl. You can see cardigan. This brown one is not going to stretch it as I squeeze it. See the way it's damping it. Can you see it? Yes. After that, she will hang it. Now, you want to wash on this. Even if you choose the dry cleaners to be washing your clothes, my dear, they cannot wash your on this. That is why you need to learn how to launder your clothes yourself. You can do it. Yes. Can you see? These are tight. It's using lukewarm water. Yes. The thing is adding there is detergent, liquid detergent. You see the way it scrubbed the leg of that tie? Small. It's not too harsh. Scrub it small. Yes, now you want to damp it. After that, you will now spread it. I hope you're getting the add small detergent. This one is polyester. Are you getting? This one, you don't even need to scrub at all. You just mash it in water, try to squeeze it in water, as in, because the wool in it will stretch, and if it stretches, it will spoil the material. Are you getting it? I hope you got the video. Yes, that is laundry for you. You launder based on the material you want to launder. Cotton, the way you launder cotton is quite different from the way you launder silk, wool, polyester, and so on and so forth. So all this you need to know, so that you know anytime you want to launder, you bring out your clothes, first of all check which type of material is this, am I going to launder or am I about to launder, then how am I going to do it. Then these are the questions you ask yourself. What type of detergent is it? Harsh detergent, mild detergent, and even little or no detergents? Are you getting? These are the things you need to put into consideration. White materials, you have to, if it is the one that is stained, add your little bleach in water to make it more sparkling. Do you understand? So you need to know how to launder. And mind you, remember, there are some materials need to be laundered every day. Your undies, nobody must launder it for you. You have to be washing them as soon as you remove them. That is why you need to learn this. You need to know how to learn. If you don't know, see, practice makes perfect. Keep practicing. You will get it more. Are you getting? And I know, but with this lesson, you'll be able to gather your own dirty clothes and that of the other members of the family and launder them to show mommy and daddy that, yes, I've learned something in this very class. Yes, I know you can do it, and I pray that God will continue to be granting you knowledge that you need, in Jesus' name, amen. That will bring us to the end of this class, practical on laundry processes. And I will still advise you, go online, take the comprehensive notes of this topic and write them, practicalize it, because I'm going to ask questions as I told you. Is that taken? Do the assignment that follows. Assignment is very important. And I gave you assignment on this practical to practicalize on material. Please make sure you do the practical. Do it exactly the way I asked you to do it. Go online, you'll see assignment. Bye for now. Still remain your home management teacher, Mrs. Oduma. See you in next class. Thank you.